So good afternoon, everyone. My name is Rahul Khatri, and I'm from DuPont, India. Let me first thanks Mr. Jaggi for the nice introduction. DuPont definitely is actually a trusted company, and then it feels feels good to hear about that from other people as well, because it shows that for the last 216 years we are doing the right work and giving the right kind of products to the industry as well. So in the previous session we have heard a lot about OMM, different practices. A point was raised by Mr. Jaggi as well in terms of the Maruti and the Mercedes, and then who is driving, and then how O&M actually holds a lot of importance in terms of overall operation of PV system. So definitely actually a lot of things were discussed, but then one question that is still there is that whether we can ensure quality of O&M. So we have heard of two different aspects. One is that how we can improve O&M practices by introducing new technologies like drones, robotic cleaning and all. On the second hand, we have also heard about the kind of pressures that are there on the cost. So we have seen in the module that definitely when there were cost pressures, and which are still are there, the quality has degraded over a period of time. Whether that's going to be there in O&M, that is what has to be seen. And I hope that does not happen, because kind of issues now that we are seeing as far as module is concerned in the field, we hope that that does not happen with regard to O&M, and people are ready to pay slightly extra amount to ensure that they have the right O&M practices, as well as when they are building plants, they have the right set of modules. So just to give an introduction in terms of what DuPont does. So DuPont, as I told you, is a 216-year-old company, and as far as PV is concerned, DuPont is this business for more than 40 years now. So I can take that crown from IBC of being the oldest company in this room. And in terms of the product, so we have basically supply materials for the manufacturing of cells and modules. We supply solamate paste, which is used on the front side of cells. We supply Tedlar film, which is used on the back side of the module in terms of back sheets. And then we have some new products as well, which can be used for making structures, making bearings for trackers, and etc. And the numbers that you can see here kind of shows the experience that we have in PV. So we are in the industry for 40 years. So some of our materials as well, like Tedlar based back sheets, are there in the field for more than 30 years. We talk about proven stuff, we talk about proven materials, proven modules. There is a live example wherein the modules with Tedlar based back sheets are actually working in the field and working well. By that I mean that working, a power loss is less than 0.8% over more than 30 years. So one more point was discussed in the last session as well, that there are two aspects as a PV project is concerned. One is the initial phase when you are actually selecting modules, selecting BOM, the kind of modules that are going to buy, doing all the testing on the modules to ensure that they are within the specifications. And the second part is the how is the next 25 years when once you have bought the modules, you have your plant installed. You want to ensure that the plant is working optimally, the performance is as expected, or maybe you can go beyond that. The issues, if the issues are there, they are addressed on time and effectively. So I would focus on the first part, that is the selection, module selection part. How a bill of material is a very critical aspect of the modules that you install in your projects. And then besides material supply, DuPont does a lot of field testing as well. So we have teams across the globe, in USA, in China, in Japan, in India as well. We go in the fields, we inspect modules mainly with the objective to understand how different materials are performing. Definitely gives us an understanding in terms of how our materials are performing, but overall we get a better idea in terms of how different materials are performing in different climatic conditions. So in India, you will see that though, yes, the PV has progressed very well in the last 5 years. In terms of long-term data, we don't have that much. But then we have data which we have collected, long-term data which we have collected from other regions, and that is what I will show in my presentation. And what I've seen, that though we are not into O&M and all, but then what we do, the kind of studies that we do in the field, there's a pretty good correlation or the learnings for the O&M community as well. So I will just skip some of the slides as well. I won't cover everything in this presentation because of the time constraint. So I will just focus on some of the third-party studies which kind of indicate the kind of impact the focus on cost has had on the quality of the modules. So this slide actually has been taken from a report which was released by TUV. It's actually a global study and then included different components across the plant. And if you look at the data on your left-hand side, there are two pie charts and kind of indicates the percentage defects in different components, be it modules, inverters, cables, and other components which are used in a typical PV plant. But then if you see the two data points, you will see there is a very high jump in the defect rate in terms of modules. From around 19% in 2012-2013, the module defect rate increased to around 48%, which kind of indicates that with time and with in terms of the modules which have been installed in the last 4 to 5 years, definitely there is a compromise in quality, and that is what has been now reflected in the field data as well. In the right-hand side, what DuPont has done is that they have segregated different defects based on the impact on the performance. So as an O&M company, you will see a lot of defects in the modules in the field. But then what is the impact of that? What could be the future impact of those defects? Some of the defects might not be leading to any power loss or any issue at that point in time. But with time, they can definitely lead to a very serious power loss or a catastrophe as well in terms of current leakage or maybe electrocution of a person. So if you look at the modules, so what they have done is that they have segregated defects in terms of the impact that they have on the performance or safety. In terms of PSD, which indicates particular serious defects, then you have serious defects and less serious defects. And if you look at the particular serious defects, you will see a PID, which is something we all know that can lead to a very high power loss in less than 1 year time frame. Then you have issues like glass breakage, in which case as well, if you have glass breakage, then your module will not perform, will not give you any output power, and you have to replace modules. And one more component which is there is the defective backsheet. So here actually the defective backsheet may not lead to any immediate power loss, but as soon as you have a defective backsheet in terms of cracking, it's an immediate safety issue. And again, we heard a lot about the numbers in terms of PRs, the kind of impact it can have on the revenues. But if you have a safety issue, and we have seen in the last maybe few months kind of issues that we have seen in restaurants in India and different factories, kind of impact it can have, kind of consequences it can lead to. So safety also is an equally important aspect, if not more than the number of units that the plant is generating in a year. So next slide is again indicating same point in terms of the loss of or the impact of focus on quality or focus on cost at the compromised quality on the performance of modules. So again, this is an ID study. So this study actually was done by IIT in 2014, but they have recently done a study in 2016, and the report has been published recently. In fact, last week only they have published this report, which is there on their website. So again, you can see in the performance. So the charts on the right hand side give the per year or the annual power degradation of the modules across different climates. So the left hand side chart is for the modules which are less than 5 years old, and the right hand side is for the chart for the modules which are more than 5 years old. And you'll be surprised to see that the average power loss in the young modules is much higher than the older modules. Again, indicates that the issues that are cropping up in the modules which have been installed recently. And in terms of again the defects, so you will see the different defects, they have assigned risk priority numbers. And again, you will see the backsheet defects getting the highest RPN numbers. Again, in terms of, not in terms of power loss, but in terms of safety. So this is actually a study being done by DuPont. What we focus on mainly when we go to the plant is the visual inspection, because that is how the best way to find out defects at plant site. Definitely you can do a lot of analysis in the lab, or if you have portable lab, or if you have lab somewhere else, you can do a lot of analysis. But the first thing that you can do without disrupting the plant is to visually inspect the modules. And then you can actually get a lot of data in terms of how the modules are performing or different components within the module are performing. So what we have observed is that across an inspection of more than 1.9 million panels, we observed that in around 11% of the panels, we found defects in the cells in terms of snail trails and in terms of hotspots. So when you talk about snail trails, people say, yes, it's a defect. But then what snail trails does is that it kind of makes cracks visible. Without doing any EL, you can find out whether you have cracks in the cell, in the modules. And then the second biggest contributor to defect is backsheet. So in around 7.5% of the inspected modules, we found found defects in the backsheet in terms of cracking, yellowing, delamination, and so on and so forth. And then 3% of the modules had EVA-related defects. So we found some correlation in terms of the environment as well, climate. So we have found that with regard to EVA and backsheet, which are polymeric materials, the defect rate increases in hot arid climates, which is something you will see in Indian climatic conditions. So in terms of again rooftop versus ground mount as well, we have seen higher defect rate in backsheets, especially in rooftop areas, mainly because of the poor air circulation at the back of the modules, and definitely in terms of the higher UV reflection, because here actually since the gap between the module and the surface is less, then that really would be in a ground mounted installation. So the impact of UV, which is reflected from the ground of a rooftop, is much higher than that in a ground mounted installation. So this actually, when you talk about backsheets, and if you look about the different materials in the stack of the module, in terms of glass, all the modules would be having glass as the base material. If you talk about encapsulant, all the modules will be having EV as the base material. But in terms of backsheet, you will see different materials are being used. And definitely a lot of this is driven by, or change in material is driven by the cost. But then the cost definitely, again, as I had shown earlier, has an implication on the long-term performance of the modules, which is something you can see here. So if we segregate the data in terms of the defect rate across different backsheets, then you'll see that in terms of PVDF, one thing is that the field data is for PVDF based backsheets not more than 5 years. So this is not a proven backsheet. Still has to be there in the field for around 20 years to claim that it's actually a backsheet which has been used in the field for around 25 years. But then this backsheet has not seen more than 5 years in the field. But within the 5 years as well, you will see a lot of variation in terms of defect rates. So some of the plants are showing 100% defect rates, means that all the modules are having defects in the backsheet. With regard to PET-based backsheets, again, you will see in terms of experience, yes, it's more than PVDF, but in terms of defect rate, it's again, there's a lot of variation. In terms of PVF, so PVF actually is something which DuPont manufactures. BVF is the chemical name, so Tedlar is the brand name. But with regard to PVF, one thing you will notice is that the experience is definitely much higher than the other backsheets. As I told you that this backsheet has been in the field for more than 30 years now, it's just a proven material. And in terms of Tedlar, we have seen some issues as well. But then again, when we talk about doing all this field analysis, we try to understand why those issues occurred. So those issues have already been rectified. It was mainly associated with using a specific design of backsheets with Tedlar-based backsheets, but that has been rectified now. And in terms of the backsheets which are being used right now, those backsheets have already been seen in more than 25 years in the field. In terms of quantifying these numbers, you can say with respect to Tedlar, the average age is 5.4 years, but then in terms of defect rate is only 0.1% on terms of megawatt basis. Whereas in terms of PVDF and polyester based backsheets, the average age is less than Tedlar. In terms of defect rate as well, is much higher than Tedlar based backsheets. So these are some of the photographs now as well. You can see yellowing happening in terms of the inner layer side or outer layer side, and then you can see cracking as well. So the picture on the right hand side, you can see the outer layer is completely gone, in fact. And I would spend 1 minute on this slide because with respect to O&M as well, this holds a very, very, very large importance. Because what we understand is that, and when one sees this kind of a defect in the field, as I told you initially, that it typically does not lead to immediate power loss. But then it's a safety issue. But as an O&M guy, in terms of the defect in the materials or in terms of backsheets, we have seen this in multiple cases in India as well. In fact, one of the cases, maybe I'm not sure if I have a picture here, but then there are multiple cases of these issues happening in Indian conditions as well. But then as an O&M person or the people who are working in the field, since they're not aware of this kind of an issue because they have never seen such issues in the field, they don't know the kind of implications that these issues can have. And then these issues will be leaking current, can leak current, and maybe the team would be operating there without knowing that the current leakage is there, which is actually a very serious. Okay. So in terms of the issues or in terms of the consequences, so since these kind of issues can lead to current leakage, so effectively actually you're operating a plant which is actually leaking current and actually is a very actually leading to a very high risk of safety. So without knowing, if you don't know that this can actually lead to such kind of consequences, you are operating a plant and definitely you are actually exposed to a very serious safety risk, and which can actually lead to an electrocution of a person as well. So what we do is that besides doing all these studies, when we get data from the field, we conduct trainings for the O&M teams, specifically on modules, but then we tell that what kind of defects you might get to see in the field. So this data we have got from other locations, but then this something can definitely happen in India. And something as I told you earlier,
please move towards the conclusion.
Sure. Yeah.
Thank you.
So something we have seen in Indian conditions as well. So what we tell them, and if they see this kind of an issue, then what kind of steps they have to take, be it in terms of reporting to the model manufacturer or in terms of taking precautions while kind of handling or testing these modules. So there are actually a lot more data in terms of what we have seen in the field, but I would just come to the conclusion. So in terms of So one more side, actually just wanted to tell you that in terms of, again, ensuring that you have the right module for your plant, working on the first stage, which is around the development of the plant. So one of the things that you can definitely do is to specify BOM. And the BOM specification, again, has to depend on what is working in the field. Right now, you don't have the right test standards to test a new material. So if you are going to use a new material, you don't know whether it's going to work in the field because they are not right test measures. So the best way to find out which is the right material is to check by for how long they're working in the field, what is the for past performance. If something is working in the field for around 25 years, then that is the right material to be included in the modules. And that is what is being followed in China. So this is one of the case studies wherein for a single 850 megawatt plant, though four different suppliers was used, one bomb was specified. And all these manufacturers use one single bomb. So this is something you can also adopt, and then definitely I would again reinforce that both the aspects in terms of development of the plant, in terms of buying modules, inverters and all, and O&M are equally important. If you're looking for a performance, Mercedes performance, then you have to have a Mercedes, buy a Mercedes, and then definitely you do have a right driver in terms of O&M who can ensure that he's maintaining the car pretty well, he's driving the car pretty well. If you're going to have a bad car or a bad quality car, right driver might not be help you much, and again there will be losses. And on the other side, if you have a good quality car, you have a Mercedes, but then if you don't have the right driver who is not maintaining car or who is driving rashly, again there will be losses. So both things are critical. Focus on both, and again I would suggest that spend a little penny on both the other aspects, because that is going to give the returns to all of you on the long run. So on this note, I would take your leave. Thank you.
Thank you so much.